Steel is good. It is known to all. And acceptance of steel is already in the market. So to begin with, I thought to share something from India's premier steel manufacturer, SAIL. They are saying this. We are all around encompassed with various items of steel in our everyday life. This is a common knowledge. Steel by far is the most important multifunctional and most adaptable material. Our civilization development is predominantly successful due to the adoption of steel in our everyday life. But why steel is good? What are the basic intrinsic properties? What make steel so great? Steel is hot and cold formable. This is very important for us, for us, the engineers. Steel is weldable. Steel is highly machinable. Steel is hard, tough, and wear resistant. Steel basically is corrosion protective, though there are certain necessity on specific circumstances. Steel is also fundamentally heat resistant unless exposed to extreme conditions. Most importantly, the supply of steel as a source is enormous. The earth crust, 5.6% of the metal is steel. We do not have to bother about the availability. Manufacturing of steel is very economic consideration too. When we convert ore to steel, the energy requirement is 25% less compared to aluminium. Most importantly, today in a world where sustainability is a very important issue, steel is highly recyclable. And we are manufacturing globally 20 times more steel if we compare all non-ferrous metals together. Hence, fundamentally steel is great and steel is here to stay. Some very simple facts. India is looking at a continuous growth path on a GDP growth. Trends in the world shows as the GDP is increasing, consumption of steel on a per capita base is increasing. You can see on the second column and the third column, the trends. China is the most glaring example. From 2010, their GDP, per capita GDP has changed where? From there, what is the per capita consumption now? I have highlighted Thailand only to draw attention in a way that we consider Thailand a similar economy, but see their GDP value and the per capita consumption. Hence, if India economically is successful to grow in the path of economics as projected GDP, sustained 7.5-8%, there is every possibility of per capita increase in steel consumption. I just want to share with you two other graphs. First, you can see on the right side, three circles I have drawn, three types of economics, USA, Canada, Germany, Japan, UK, the developed countries. You can see their per capita income on the vertical axis and the horizontal is the per head steel consumption. So it shows the trend is they have in between somewhere plateaued, 400-500 kg per person per capita, when they are on the very high GDP trend. But Look at Taiwan and Korea. It gives a very different flavor. Their GDP is at the $30,000-$40,000, but their consumption is more than 1,000 kg per person. The graph shows very high increase in case of Korea, the blue graph. The developed countries are showing a slight downtrend. But bottom half is the developing economies. The developing economies definitely has ample scope to increase their steel consumption. If we really change our per capita GDP, there is high possibility of growth in steel industry. So this is from the world trends. The world, how they consume? The 50% is roughly in construction industry. The rest is well spread in transport, other things. But India, construction is more than 60%. Our other areas are much low. This is from care ratings. You can see again why India has ample scope for increase in steel consumption. Because the last three heads, we have still to grow at least to 10% of the figure. So by these figures and the charts, everything, we can assume with economic development and seeing the world trends, steel consumption vis-a-vis steel production is bound to increase. But now the economy is still at a plateau stage. Market capex investment is still not that much picking up. So at this moment, as an organization, what we are doing, I just want to share with this August hall where we are. We are into an asset integrity management, which is a very new area in steel plant. This is an old trend or already established in oil and hydrocarbon sector, but steel plant or in an organized way, asset integrity is not yet that much established. Why this requirement? All the steel plants are very old in the world, but they are capable to meet the present requirement. So what is the requirement? They need to be proper upkeep and maintenance in a structured manner for their sustainability vis-a-vis improved productivity. The trend shows a greenfield steel plant in future, not so much, rather than upgradation, retrofit of the existing facility, adding of the capacity to them. So this calls for asset integrity management. In asset integrity management, we are trying to outline the ability of an asset to perform the required function effectively and efficiently while protecting the health, safety, and environment. What we try to achieve? To specify the integrity functionality, the final outcome, including probable lifespan and license to operate. Why this basic target or goal in asset integrity in a steel plant? Assets are aging. License to operate is very important from the licensing bodies or a statutory body's requirement, law enforcement. And the health is deteriorating. The asset needs to remain fit to purpose. Just to introduce you how it is being done, it's a normal PDCA cycle. asset plan and objective, set the goal, then asset integrity implementation, then perform, then again review and change as a complete PDCA cycle. I tried to draw a life cycle of the process, only to introduce how this is being implemented in a still plant-specific industry. The steps and methodology may be a bit different in a hydrocarbon industry. This is being done in certain European plants at present. And this is the life cycle process of the whole activity. Framework, most importantly, inspection strategy. This is one of the very key area. Then, training of the resources, all the related resources, again becomes very important because this calls for a change in mindset of the people involved. I shall bring to us next slide, why. Inspection and report, whole activity is looked from a risk perspective. Whole assets are mapped in an asset register and their risk perspective, risk scaling is complete. Then from the risk perspective, the next step, call for engineering, call for implementation, retrofit, everything starts. Now, when we are doing this, we have found out a few challenges. What is the technical challenge? In India, still we are not having relevant texts or codes. We have to refer to ISO 55000 and NIN. Netherlands has a very nice code 2767, which gives guideline how to form the risk matrix. Another area is the experience or change in mindset required because of identifying risk or problem first from a visual inspection point of view. Knowledge of fatigue, dynamic, and aging due to natural forces. Knowledge of effect of sustaining process and equipment behavior after prolonged usage. These are two main areas which has become or is faced as a technical challenge. And in way of we are working, one of the fundamental change required that when you are dealing with an aging assets, you have to have a mindset that you will not have all the information required. Our expectation that all 2D, all technical information will be available. Here the activity is being done based on laser scanned point cloud data being converted to as built 3D model. So whole work or way of work is completely different rather than how we do a greenfield project. Orientation of the my mindset for working on an as-built asset rather than building a new one. Then there are challenges due to the meeting of expectation. When people are on a retrofit, upgradation, life expectancy increase in such work, the client's expectation is different. Expectation of the construction agency is a bit different. They are getting not the conventional 2D drawings directly they can convert. They are getting some 3D model as an input, 2D extracted drawings. They are getting certain guidelines, the NDT test results, various things. So here also the challenge or the expectation of the executing agency is a bit different. And as it is being done on international, their quality demand is different. So this is the brief where at present we are doing work, or this is the new area in steel plant. In India, this is also is starting, not health study, etc., in very unorganized manner, but it has bound to change in a more systematic way. I want to just end by showing one video where an asset has been converted or upgraded, and a 4D model was part of the pre-engineering pack given to the construction agency for their idea or guidance on a constructability issue. Whole 3D model was done, steel structure on Tekla, and rest of the items were done on Autodesk 3D platform. 4D was done on a Navis work model. Video. Here, as you show, it is a short video. It was an existing facility. Reds are to be dismantled. Greens are the new facility to be added. They will be visible on sequence. And sequential dismantling will be visible in red. First, the foundations as a part of strengthening is being added through piling. Then there are certain defunct pipelines being removed. This is a short, roughly 200-meter existing facility where in past conveyor gallery, many pipelines used to go. Conveyor is not required, and part of the pipeline is to be rerouted due to the deteriorating health. Even as it is an international project where scaffolding for a safety reason for workmen has to be built up is shown in the model. You can see the green rerouting pipeline areas are being now added in the model. On the left hand side, you can see now many the strengthening and retrofit activity being shown. As it is a 4D, everything is matched with a time period of construction. As I have made into a 2-minute video, so something sequence may get bit different, but steps are very clear. Now comes the major activity, where the crane has to be put in a running existing plant and which part to be dismantled, also shown in the model. If it is a one crane activity, it is a multi-crane activity, everything is modeled. It is not, the contractor is not bound to follow this, but this is for their guidance, where to place, how to do, to start up. So otherwise, in a running plant, safety becomes a very critical issue. The deteriorated or defunct